It's Boyz Night.
Boyz.
I can't wait to live in tonight.
Boyz Night Out. Boyz Night Out tonight.
We're here with Zach Show Live, and we're just waiting for Daryl Sweat to pop on the line.
How's everyone doing? You heard it right. It is Boyz Night. This episode is going to be only boys, so we might get a little raunchier than normal. So if you are not of age, please do take a second and ask your parental advisor if you can listen to this show. And if you can't, I'm sorry, because you're going to miss a good one.
Because this is Boyz Night Out. No girls.
What's up, guys? Welcome to the SEO show.
This is the show where we look at Google search trends and talk about them so that we come up in search results. Lately, we've been imitating Drake remixes. If you're here because of that, welcome. Should we give them another Drake remix?
I guess while we wait for, let's give a, so everyone, we've been basically clickbaiting our, episodes with Drake images, modified Drake images that Ryan's actually been making.
So and... I'm on YouTube. Yeah. And so like people think that this is actually into this song so hard right now. So they're looking for like that
in
song,
my feelings. Yeah.
In my feelings. It's everywhere. So, like, we've been getting a lot of traffic because people have just been, you know, believing the clickbait that it's a Drake remix, and it's not. I don't know if they're actually listening to more of it.
I mean, the song has remained popular. The song has the dance that got all these other, like, you know, fucking famous people doing it. So, it's still in circulation. So, it still is hot trending news. And that's what we cover.
We just had Daryl Sweat on the line. Daryl, we were just saying... we're still clickbaiting people over that Drake track in my feelings, and we're going to keep doing it.
That's great. I got to say that some of the original artwork you've been providing for that franchise, I got to say, is great.
Yeah, I spend a lot of time on it, like, sometimes.
Depending on how much time I have. I think Drake would be proud.
Yeah. It's been said before that Drake has made his music videos and album artwork and stuff very photoshoppable so that memes can be made of it. I don't know if
really?
That's true, but it was like a couple think pieces about it, like at least one.
Yeah. Couple of think pieces. I haven't heard that one in a while.
So I was just going to give the people who are actually looking for Drake In My Feelings remixes like a little taste of somebody who has actually remixed a Drake track. I'm just going to YouTube and typing in Drake In My Feelings remix and looking at the album artwork, just some of these thumbnails and names. I'm going to play Drake In My Feeling RJS Trap Nation remix. How do you think this one's going to be?
Probably fine.
Dank.
Trap, money, penny. Got me in my feelings. Gotta be real with it.
No.
Yep. Kiki, do you
love me? So far not hearing much difference. I'm gonna skip ahead to see if something happens.
When it's stopping and we get the top, and I see that you've been learning. And when I take you shopping, you spin it like you.
Okay, so the description said this music is not a real trap mix. It's just visuals and amplified vocals.
Trap, mini, mini.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Well, you know. That gave us a little taste of the song, guys. I'm sure you've heard it a million times.
Yeah, in case you forgot.
Yeah, I don't hate it. I still like it.
No, it's good. It's good.
And the music video came out last week, so it's like we just hit another wave.
Yeah.
Can you watch music videos on Spotify?
Good question. I don't know. Oh, I don't really use it.
There's a beach house song that has like an integrated visual type thing.
That's what you have to do. That's like the only thing that you can do, I think. And I did see that Beach House one because I was like, oh, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
Hold on, I'm going to try one more remix.
Cold to the paint.
I'll say that one's pretty good. That one's Drake and My Feelings DN4 remix.
Do you want my? So,
I'm just throwing some traffic to the real remixers.
Do you want to know my trick for finding remixes? The firest remixes.
What?
You want to go on SoundCloud and you want to search for the ones that have high reshares and like 14,000 plays. That way you know it's like still pretty underground, but people are feeling it.
14,000 is the number.
Yeah.
Okay.
It depends on how sub your genre is. If it's like if you're in a deep subgenre and it's got like 800 plays, then you're like, okay.
I mean, are you like actively looking for remixes of songs?
I mean, yeah, I listen to a lot of chiptune music, so they're all about that remix. A lot of chiptune music, so that's what they live on.
What is that?
Chiptune? Yeah, it's like video game chipmunk? Type music.
No, it's not like chipmunk. It is using frequency modulation. That's FM modulation for my mod heads out there.
Huh. Okay. I guess I don't know what that is.
It's a thriving community, my man.
Chip tunes.
Here, wait, check it out.
That sounds like it's like it's kind of like pulp.
Yeah.
Shit. Is this Drake?
Yeah, this is In My Feelings Chip Tune Remix. Pretty good.
Interesting.
Pretty good.
So that's nice. Good.
Yeah, you didn't know what chiptune. I can't believe you didn't know what chiptune was.
No.
That just shows you like how much of a bigger like I'm so much more in the nerd world.
Yeah.
Should we get into the topics?
What are we doing right now?
We're doing an SEO show.
Oh, nice. Finally, some search engine optimization in my life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you were absent last week, so honestly don't even remember what we talked about. But
well, we didn't do so if you're a fan of SEO show.
Oh, we didn't do SEO last week. Oh, gotcha.
No, I really slacked on it hard. I was launching the Chunkcast.
Right.
Oh, that's cool though.
The Wendy Chunkcast fan or Wendy Chunkcast fan.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
But
about
like,
this.
I say that's the reason. But really, like, this show doesn't take any effort, so I really don't have an excuse. Like, honestly, like we go to Google Trends. Right now, I'm at trends.google.com. I'm going to trending searches, and I'm looking at what the top searches are. Right now, as per usual, a SEO show theme: sports.
Sports guys.
Red Sox is the top search right now. It's at 500K. I mean, this is not the end of the day yet. So like, actually, it's kind of some slow traffic on the net the last couple days. Honestly, like the top searches of the last couple days aren't even hitting 1 million.
Right. Well, let's just say this is 500K for the Red Sox. Apparently, they clinched their division, so they're going to the playoffs. I mean,
you're going to the stakeoff.
They're going to the playoffs, yes. Which, I mean, cool. Like, honestly, who cares? I mean, like, does anyone actually like the Red Sox? No. So let's just move on to number two.
Buzz Night Out.
That's right. We're being a little extra harsh today because we got no ladies here. So fuck the Red Sox.
It's a Buzz Night Out. No girls.
Hit that fart button if it's a Buzz Night Out.
Ryan.
So yeah, Alex Jones. Sorry. Alex Jones, guys.
Oh yeah,
he's banned.
Do you know, like, the? Can you give us an explainer? I feel like you've probably been surrounded by this story, and I feel like you probably know the details the most.
Yes. Who's Alex Jones again?
Okay, so Alex Jones is the like figurehead. I'm gonna say. News guy for a fake publication called InfoWars. And InfoWars is not a fake publication like The Onion. It's not supposed to be satire. It's all conspiracy theories, and notably all essentially right-wing conspiracy theories. And this is, you know, they dabble in even the deep stuff like
the dark arts.
Yeah.
Chemtrails. No, they don't
like witchcraft and shit.
No. Like
they dabble in like Hollow Earth.
Yeah.
Didn't he say that, like, somebody like Barack Obama smelled like sulfur, like he smelled like brimstone?
Yes, him and Hillary Clinton, they're literally demons, guys.
Yeah. That's what, he said they smell like hell.
Yeah.
That's a really good one. I got to get the clip, actually. Like,
yeah.
Continue talking, and I'm going to get
this.
Is this guy reptilian?
He might be a reptile because he's trying to call everyone, like, you know, you point the finger at somebody else, you got three fingers pointing back at you.
That's right.
He's three times a reptile, but he does he's reptile. He does believe in the reptiles a little bit or something.
Yeah, he has the famous quote that the government is putting stuff in the water to make that it's making the frogs gay.
I don't know that one.
It's great. And yeah, so I mean, his website basically he's got like a multi.
Oh my god! Income. This is the guy that has the fucking show where he just yells.
Yeah.
Oh god, I hate this guy.
And they sell like male virility supplements on there. Not the real stuff, but just
what
like
the fuck does that mean? What does that mean?
The like horny just... goat weed supplements.
Oh, that shit works, dude.
Okay. Well. Listen, they make. I'm just saying they have two major sources of income. It used to be advertising and like supplements, but then like last year, maybe the year before, all their ads got pulled pretty much. So they were just making like AdSense money on YouTube, and then supplement money.
Horny goat weed, fucking paying up.
All kinds of stuff like fish oils, all manner of shit. Oh yeah, prepper food. They love to sell prepper food.
It's
as
basically
well.
Like selling fear, right? Like
100%.
That's like kind of like the idea. It's like you get people scared and then you offer them the solution to it.
Okay.
Which is like
so,
supplements and prepping gear.
I'm in the supplement game. Do you guys take fish oil?
I don't know, because I'm allergic to fish.
Negative.
Do you guys take multivitamins?
No.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I don't know. It's just like
I eat a lot of vegetables and I feel like those probably have a lot of stuff in them.
I mean, vegetables, I mean, I could be wrong, but I don't think vegetables have fish oil in them.
No, but I mean, like, what would be in, like, a multivitamin? Multivitamins don't have fish oil.
Yes,
like
vegetables have lots of vitamins. I don't know about specifically fish oil. I would expect it.
I wasn't saying they have a fish oil. I was saying
I know what you're saying. I mean, I'm just curious.
I can't enjoy fish oil because I'm allergic to fish. I'll never know.
Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah. Well, I don't know, because I was taking fish oil, and I'm like, what is this? I'm like, why is it? I mean, obviously it's fish oil, but it's like, okay, I don't know if it's actually doing anything, or I'm just, you know, giving more money to Alex Jones type figures.
Yeah, like, I think I actually heard recently it's all fake.
I think
it's
fake.
Nothing.
Yeah,
like I think there was a few, like from what I remember, like very recently, hearing some reputable sources saying like, oh, fish oil is nothing.
Yeah.
So you're just taking it just to have a fish burp.
Exactly. And to feel better about yourself and to make somebody money.
It's just fucking.
It's probably a lot of like, there's probably like the fish oil, fish industry. Like, I bet you they had a bunch of fish oil that they're like, what are we going to do with this?
Yeah.
And then they were like, we'll make people think they, you know.
Oh, wait. So
same
anyway.
Thing that the aluminum industry did with fluoride in our water.
Ooh, bringing it right back to Alex Jones. So anyway, so the news is that he got fucking band hammered. First, he got banned on Apple Podcasts. Then Facebook, then YouTube. And I was watching the Periscope today, and I wouldn't say he's having a meltdown any more than he has a meltdown normally about everything else, but he was...
It's hard to tell, boy who cried wolf style.
That's right. But he was, like, begging everyone to join the newsletter, which, you know, can't really be banned very easily, and download the app, which could be banned, but probably won't be, because it's definitely different terms of service for the app versus like, YouTube and whatever.
Mm-hmm. So pretty crazy. What's he gonna do?
I mean, he's probably just gonna keep going on because he already has a core audience.
Yeah, they're gonna find him wherever he is.
Yeah. My question is do you guys think that this is censorship? That's what the conservatives are saying. It's censorship and that we should be afraid.
Well, the thing is like, we were saying, like, okay, Alex Jones is doing this because he wants to, like, my take is, like, he's selling fear, and then he's selling the antidote for fear, which is, like, snake oil, but, like, you know, placebo, whatever.
Right.
But, like, if he actually believes in, like, you know, that Obama smelled like hell, like, he might actually just be crazy. But so like, sure. I mean, you know, does he actually believe what he's saying? How can you prove that he actually believes what he's saying?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's the core question. That's what Zuck has asked a number of times. But, you know.
I mean, I think the...
Go ahead, sorry.
No, you're good. Go ahead.
Oh, you know, I mean, the question is like, is it hurting anyone? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And there's definitely been cases where it for sure is hurting people. Right? Like, you can be on YouTube and just be like, I believe in celestial beings. I have been abducted, you know? And in none of those cases you're really, like, hurting anyone else. People are just like, oh, cool, this guy's, like, either a character or whatever. But, you know, Alex Jones was peddling a conspiracy that the victims of the Sandy Hook school shooting were, A, fake, that there were no victims, and that their parents and other children were crisis actors. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I remember that hurts exactly. People. That hurts.
I remember my aunt believed that conspiracy. Like, she's talking to me about it.
Mm. Who?
Aunt Money.
Oh, nah.
Yeah. And she was like,
oh my God.
She was like, you got to look into it, Ryan. Like, just let me know, like, what you just got to
Google.
She really wanted my opinion. She would respect my opinion if I told her that no, it's real.
Yeah.
I never actually got back to her. I probably should have. I was like, I'm pretty sure it's real, though, in the moment. I was like, I haven't checked the facts, but I'm going to have to go through it.
My sister's a pretty big sucker for conspiracies.
They're so fun, though. I mean, we've talked about it before. It puts you, like, in a really cool world where, like, you know the secret.
Yeah. Oh, it's true. That's true. It's so fun to be – well, that's what – yeah. I think we talked about it at the time. Like, alternate reality games feel very similar, so I would suggest people find some of those.
Oh, if you're, like, sucked into conspiracies, you just actually got to become, like, a gamer or something?
Yeah.
That's what you're suggesting? Like, replace – you've always got a void to be – to feel, like, important, and so you got to become a gamer?
Well, I mean, yeah, there's this, like, little, you know, this, like, frenzy mentality where it's like, oh, we're all digging up the truth together on Reddit. Oh, my God, we got to get a Discord together. We got to talk about it and the pieces and the crumbs and the hints and the clues.
I feel like I got crumbs, though.
Yeah.
I'd love to contribute some crumbs to a community.
There you go. I mean, just got to, I mean, listen, the guy, okay, so a separate but somewhat related story is QAnon. And we don't have to go into everything that happened on QAnon, but they don't really know who did it. So somebody is it's not a decentralized like meme. It's a centralized meme. As in, like, there was one guy who got on 4chan or whatever and said, like, I am Q. I've got the secrets that'll help you bring together this government pedophile ring. And, you know, of course the conservatives love a pedophile secret society. But they don't really know who Q is, and so, like, so a BuzzFeed article that came out today, which was very bad, was like, there's definitely a chance that this could be like a beautiful liberal troll, which is, like, definitely probably not likely.
I don't understand, but, like, what the troll is, though. Can you go back to that? Like, what's the... How is this provoking anything? Like, what is this?
What the deal is? Okay, so...
QAnon. What the flip is that?
Q. The letter Q.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, honestly, I have literally
don't understand. I'm still, like, I don't even understand what you're saying. Like, this is, like, maybe, like, take, like, a step back.
Yeah, okay. So QAnon is, like, the conspiracy of the week, right? At a recent Trump rally, there were a bunch of, like, boomer age people holding up signs that were like, I am Q. We believe Q is real. You know, shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
Which set off a series of reports this week about QAnon. And, I'm going to be honest with you. I have tried not to learn what the QAnon conspiracy is, because what the conspiracy actually consists of is not important, and it's not something that needs to be in my brain. What's important is that people are showing up to Trump rallies with little printed out pieces of paper that says, I believe in Q.
But what did Q say?
I don't know. That's what I'm saying. I deliberately attempted not to read.
Okay.
I don't want to know.
Without knowing anything about it, I'm going to say it's part of Sacha Baron Cohen's show or like something like that.
Ooh, that'd be cool. Are they still taping the show? Like, are they still doing episodes of the show?
Probably not, you know.
Yeah.
No, they I'm sure they're done at this point.
Or they're like saving one, at least the last ones, to play out in real time.
How about right, nice. I think they still have some on deck.
I don't know. It's kind of weird.
I don't know. I mean, you know, if I was them, I would maybe put a couple of those on ice and wait.
Oh, sorry. God. It's okay.
Sorry, I was trying to play a sound effect, but I accidentally used like hit play.
Yeah, I was saying that. I'd probably put a couple of those episodes on ice and save it for later. But speaking of ice, you guys remember that movie Mighty Ducks?
I sure do.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, child actor Shaun Weiss was arrested for public intoxication, and this mugshot is dropped, and it's, you know, it's pretty sad. And this is. This is Goldberg.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm looking at the mugshot. Goldberg. The mugshot is he's not looking.
Whoa. Good.
How old is he? That's what I'm wondering.
I'd say he's looking at a rough 46 right there.
He looked like
That's a really rough 46. Jesus. Yeah.
He looks like the first picture, he looks like his name is like Tommy, and the second one, the current one, he looks like his name is Zeke.
I don't know about that.
I don't know what that means, but Tommy definitely got Zeke'd.
Yeah. That's exactly what I'm saying.
I get it now.
He was not out. Sorry, I'm just going to do my own sound effects now so they're not harsh.
What kind of intoxication? Oh, no.
I don't even know. Apparently, this is not like a new thing, but it's happened like a few times.
Oh, he was reportedly caught with meth. It's a very meth mugshot.
Yeah.
That's too bad. That's very sad. I mean,
yeah.
I think he's gonna come back. He's gonna bounce back for sure.
I think so too. You want to know why? Because it's the Boyz Nite out.
That's right.
I think it's because Ducks Fly Together and like maybe something like.
Oh, who the? Somebody dropped.
Whoa!
Shit.
Sorry,
he popped in and out.
I swiped down from the top to see my notifications. I guess in Anchor they were like, you know what this gesture would be good for? Let's close the call.
Wow.
And I was like, oh cool. Anyway, do we move on to the next?
No boys, no boys. Oh wait, no girls, no girls. It's a Boyz Nite out. Next one.
Air quality.
God, do we really want to talk about this?
No.
I feel like all I've been doing is talking about air quality lately. No.
Yeah, we don't.
I know it sucks.
It's bad. Like, Sacramento.
That's the news, people.
Guys, it's because of the forest fires. If you haven't been paying attention to this podcast, pay attention right now. The air sucks, okay? Get back to work.
Some of it's even on fire. Some of it is even actually on fire.
You know how sometimes when you see like people from China or Japan wearing face masks on the street?
Yeah,
like
do we need to do that? Bad air can.
Yeah, we should be doing it, but we're just not.
Fuck.
I
think I'm gonna do it for real. Like when I'm out, like riding the bus and shit.
I gotta say, like the Asians are good at wearing masks when they need to, and also I see them walking around with umbrellas on sunny days. I'm like, that's probably a better idea than sunscreen. Like we're dummies, but no, you don't see anyone else doing it. They're like so smart. They're carrying around shade with them.
I do see some ladies here in New York rocking the umbrellas on hot days.
Non-Asian? Yeah.
Just some regular, some ladies.
Some like really like classy kind of like old style like New York like women.
No, I wouldn't even say that. I would just say like.
Like just good. This like classy ass women.
So you're saying
just ladies, just normal just women.
Just ladies just being like, nope, not fucking with this.
A couple of them fair-skinned ladies.
The regular bodega umbrella, and I'm like, respect. And I also, but Ryan, I also agree. I'm like, damn, I should do that. That's so much smarter than just getting skin cancer for that.
Like, also, like, walking around with a face mask and an umbrella, it's like, well, let's just go to Mars already. I'm basically wearing a spacesuit.
Yeah, when we go on our trip, should I just have, like, one of those industrial industrial hazmat helmets?
Yeah, that's what's required to get in at all like national parks now.
Yeah, yeah. That makes sense. Keep me in, keep the nature out. I got it.
Exactly. You like, you shit into your pants and like. Yeah.
There's like a docking module for it. It's a whole thing. It's a whole thing.
But it's still as it always was, you know, you pack it in, you pack it out. So.
That's right.
Yeah. So yeah, let's move on. What do we got here? These searches are really low.
Robert Redford. Yeah, I know.
Just in general.
Like the web is 200K.
What the fuck?
The web is quiet.
That is weird. I feel like we need to stir some shit up.
There was like yesterday 200K searches, like the second thing, Michael J. Fox, death scare. He's still alive.
Hell yeah.
Not real.
Why was it? Was he?
It was like a hoax or something. It was like a fake report.
Fuck.
Check this out. Okay. Looks like there was an earthquake in Indonesia, 6.9.
Jeez.
Damn, dude.
What search is that on?
That is on number 9 for yesterday. So, with only 50K searches, but like, you know, I'm kind of like interested in like events like this, like natural disasters. Is that what this is categorized?
Like, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Yes.
Earthquake seems like almost the most natural disaster. You know what I mean?
I mean, because it just fucking, like, destroys shit, because it's, like, the Earth's plates are shifting, am I right?
Yeah, like, I mean, like, because a hurricane is one, too, but, like, arguably we are, like, doing that to ourselves, you know? Like, yeah. Making them worse. Like, I don't know if we're making earthquakes happen more through global warming.
I don't think so.
I think those are kind of on their own. That's what I'm saying. They're the most natural. They're most disconnected from us. Like, they're the most freak accidents. That and, like, solar flares.
Yeah. We can't do shit about solar flares.
I don't even know what that is, but
just giant like bursts of like energy.
So prayers out to Indonesia. Let's go ahead and move on.
Wait, do you guys think it's cool that the outside of the Earth is called the crust?
Yeah.
Why?
I'll say confidently, yes, I do think that's cool.
Like,
you have a problem with that?
No, just imagine like peeling it back like a thin buttery crust.
Yeah, that's kind of what I like about it.
That's
peeling it back like an orange.
Speaking of the crust and speaking of Hollow Earth earlier, I was watching some like I think it was like Wired video or something about the hum, the conspiracy of the hum, where like people just hear a deep, deep hum, like,
oh, whoa, yeah, whoa, yeah, whoa, yeah. Whoa.
You heard about it?
I've heard about the hum, but almost nothing. Like, I've just heard
it's all over the earth, like people hear it all over the place. And I swear I heard it one time. And some people think it's because the earth's actually like that's like a hollow earth theory that like there's actually big, big like caverns inside,
space.
and they're like, like resonating.
Do you think like ancient humans live in there in like a super advanced society? And they're just
I know, right?
Right under our feet.
Well, that's where the reptiles are, in like these crystal caves.
This is very I like the aesthetic that they've got at the very. I'll give them that. Their aesthetic sounds cool as fuck.
Mm-hmm. It's basically like if you crack open a geode, you know what I'm talking about?
Absolutely.
All those crystals. That's pretty much what their whole town is made out of. That's just like dirt. To Man, reptiles.
Can I live there? I can see why people want to seek this out.
It'd be cool to live in reptile land.
Well, yeah. So anyway, prayers for Indonesia. You know, I hope everything is good to go.
Positive vibes for all the non-religious people, which I would assume is at least half of the listeners.
Major ups for cosmic luck.
What?
Said major ups for cosmic luck.
That's right. We got queued up, anyone?
Queued up, a bit it out, queued up, Boyz Nite out. No, I don't have anything queued up. But actually, I mean, one thing
garbage.
I was psyched about.
I'm just looking at just garbage news.
50K
right here,
searches
so.
On Saturday, which is like, you know, wow, we're really scraping the bottom of the barrel.
We do what we need to
But I was psyched about this news. Patrick Stewart coming back to Star Trek.
Oh, hell yeah.
Jean-Luc Picard. If Zach, for you, you remember the bald guy. with.
Yeah, yeah, I'm seeing him.
Man,
yeah, he looks like a fucking cool ass dude.
He was.
Have you not seen the original? Not the original, but the Star Trek that had Mr. Stewart, Sir Patrick Stewart.
Thank you for correcting yourself.
Yeah.
At if you're on Twitter at Sir Pat Stew.
That's right.
I haven't seen it. No.
It is pretty good. And it lives up to the hype, I think.
Yeah, no. Maybe I have seen it, but I'm not sure.
It's hard. Like, I've tried to get people into it, and it takes the right personality, honestly. There's a lot of people I know that get into it.
It definitely does. It's very much like a set show, you know?
It's cool, though. Like, it's sci-fi. It's, like, the best kind of sci-fi, and, like, it's, like, a TV show, so they didn't have, like, a ton of money for special effects, so...
It's also like pretty chill vibes, like.
Yeah, definitely the sound of the ship. Like, if you go on YouTube, you'll find like hours and hours of like the sound of like the USS Enterprise deck, and it's just like whoa, 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 whoa. Actually, speaking of the hum, sounds like the hum a little bit.
Oh, but that's cool.
It's like relaxing to hear the hum of the bridge of the Enterprise for some people.
Yeah, it's gonna be for me. I'm definitely listening to that tonight. It's amazing. It's gonna be the.
But that's cool though, like. This was the one with Flippin'. Do you think what's his name?
Data.
Flippin'. Oh man, I hope Data comes back. I really like. This is a great cast, and Geordi.
This is a great cast. Oh my god.
Geordi LaForge, if you remember the Reading Rainbow guy,
yeah,
with like the visor. Man, this is definitely an iconic series. The first one, I tried watching the original series, and it was kind of crap.
Yeah, with what's his name? Guy who's like a, I don't know.
Geico
commercial. No, I was gonna flame him, but then I didn't really remember whether or not he was a racist or not, but maybe.
Oh, what's his name?
I don't know.
You know.
You know, holy Star Trek dude. Shit.
What?
I'm too lazy to even search his name.
Guys, this is crazy.
Huh.
This just in, WWE's Kane is the new mayor of Knox County, Tennessee.
Wow.
He did it.
Wow.
He freaking did it. Kane, the wrestler.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah.
Wait, that's like hot off the presses?
Yeah, because they're doing their little election thingamajig tonight.
So that just happened?
Actually it was from a couple days ago, but still. I'm just seeing pictures of Kane, and like apparently he's like the mayor, and it's just kind of fucking funny.
Wow, is number 16 Beyonce's Vogue interview has the internet asking what is a FUPA? Do you guys have that?
Probably. I didn't see it. I'll look for it
for Monday number 16.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what is that? I actually saw that and kind of just like glazed over it.
Do we want to explain this?
Oh, Beyonce's. Oh, so look, from Quartz, Beyonce's Vogue interview has the internet asking, "What is a FUPA?" It's a front butt.
Yeah, a little snippet from this article, also unprecedented, was Beyonce's casual use of the term FUPA in her interview, slang for fat upper pubic area. Or fat upper pussy area. The word has probably never appeared in a Vogue story, and the acronym was not spelled out in the interview.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to give a huge, huge shout out to Bay for normalizing normalizing the term FUPA.
Was she trying to say she has one and she likes it?
I don't know what she said.
What's the context?
I don't know. Okay, let me see.
I see it here. She used the term after describing the weight gain she experienced after giving birth to her twins earlier this year. This is a quote. To this day, my arms, shoulders, breasts, and thighs are fuller. I have a little mommy pouch, and I'm in no rush to get rid of it. I think it's real. That mommy pouch, she goes, her little FUPA. She called it her little FUPA. And she's totally fine with it.
That's cool. She kind of feels like a kangaroo a little bit, just like on downtime.
That's amazing. She feels completely comfy with the FUPA, and I love that.
I mean, I have no idea what
FUPA you think that would we could make like you think you know how like lingerie sometimes like highlights certain areas, like they'll have lingerie with the nips cut out, lingerie with the badge cut out. You know, do you think we can have like a FUPA fetish? Do you like? I'm gonna actually go on Pornhub right now.
Wow.
I'm gonna search FUPA, see if there how many people like have a FUPA pet fetish.
Apparently, it's medically called a paniculus. Loose layer of fat tissue left over from rapid weight loss or pregnancy that hangs over the lower abdominal area. It can also be caused by obesity. In rare cases, hang over the abdomen to the knees. Ooh, that's a bad one.
I don't think that's. I mean, sure. I think maybe that's the. That's medical...
like a
big.
That's like a. Like,
that's a very large paniculus.
Yeah.
Yeah. This, I think, is just when...
It's still paniculus.
Is it still paniculus? I mean, I don't know. I didn't know we were getting it. Okay. You know what?
It's definitely still paniculus.
I'm not here to split pupils.
How do you spell paniculus?
It's in the freaking article, dude.
Wait, the article I was reading?
Yes.
Oh, paniculus. Okay. The
paniculus.
Paniculus sounds like a very fun, like thing to say when something's great.
Yeah, I don't know. Like,
I mean, what are we saying miraculous. About FUPAs?
There are people on Pornhub who want to fab to a FUPA because like there's a couple FUPA videos here. There's one guy like fucking a FUPA.
Oh Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. You guys ever think about what it would be like to run for office and then someone takes one of these podcasts and they're like, yes.
I know, right? I talked about it. Like, didn't we talk about it on this podcast?
I don't even know.
I mean, I just have so much crap that I feel like I said just like off the cuff and I'm like, that's not, that wasn't very nice.
Yeah, for sure. I often say stuff and I immediately regret it. And I'm like, that's on the show.
Do you think that that's just the way that podcasting is, though? And like, no matter what your format or
probably
delivery, like, you just feel like this is going to get me in trouble.
But like, whenever I'm just being more free flowy, that's whenever I feel like it's like a better show.
Right. I guess the shows that are like, I don't know, like Gimlet Media bullshit where it's all scripted for the most part.
Yeah, they're not gonna fuck up. I mean,
yeah, they're fine.
But this is more of a yay style, poop de scoop style podcast. So, I guess you know, take that for what it's worth.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of poop de scoop, it's the 15th season of Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Can you believe it?
I really can't believe it.
It's insane how like relevant they're. Family has been able to be for so long.
Truly, truly. I've never watched it ever. I've never watched a single ep either.
I've seen a few for sure.
You like it? Watchable?
It's not bad. It's watchable. It's just like I don't know. I'd rather watch a vlog, you know? Like it's just
like
it's,
you watch the last editing's
better.
You watched the most recent season of Jersey Shore, and that's a show that I've watched a lot of, which I would put in the same place as Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Would you say was Jersey Shore better than Keeping Up with the Kardashians?
Yeah, because Keeping Up with the K is just literally like they're kind of just living their life. They're not necessarily like hanging out and like having like family dinners where there's more possibilities for like funny shit to happen. And like they're not like going out and like, you know, doing little. They do shit, but like it's like. They're not that funny.
Smaller things are the big drama.
And the guys on Jersey Shore are actually like, some of them are fucking funny. Like, Benny's pretty funny. So,
and do they have challenges in Jersey Shore? Did they ever do challenges?
No. I don't think they ever had straight up.
They had to work at like a t-shirt shop, I think.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
Or like an ice cream shop.
That was the only thing they had to do, yeah.
Yeah, but like real world style where like real world people had to have jobs, I think.
But like jobs that they could lose, right? Like fake jobs.
Exactly.
Fake jobs that they could blow up in.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, whatever they got to do for the fucking episode.
That's right.
But, like, I don't know. I don't know how, like, far. I don't know. I can't even, like. I don't even want to talk about the Kardashians. Like, I don't even know why I brought it up.
Do you think that like they have an like, X factor?
Or do you I think, don't.
Like, what do you think the appeal is?
I mean, like, they're all, like, pretty hot. Like, I'm not gonna, like, I'm. That's for sure. But.
Thing is, like, I don't even think they're. I think they're. I guess it's because there are a lot of them. But, like, I don't actually. I feel like there's gotta be one that's, like, out of control hot. And I feel like they're all, like, you know, pretty hot.
I think that what it is like.
Pretty out of
I guess like, so. You're right. Like, sorry, like I take it back.
They're just. They're just normal. They're normal people, and their mom is like a business marketing genius, right? And so, like, I really sort of feel like it's smart mom is trying to just like look out for all of her weirdo rich kids.
Yeah, I think when it comes down to it, that's a pretty good point.
Do you think I was talking about this the other day? You think that Kendall and Kylie like have no personality because they grew up on camera and they. Just decided to hide their emotions because so that they wouldn't be criticized for anything.
I think this is something that we'd have to actually get Kendall and Kylie on the show and talk to.
But them do you know what I'm talking about? They're so fucking plain. They're like Twilight level emotionless. You know what I'm talking about?
Okay, like, are they? Do they just know how to play the game?
That's
like,
what I'm saying. Just... See, here's the thing: is that like before. Like when I was growing up, I didn't really think like no, there was no context for like being media trained. You know what I mean? Like,
where are you from? Where are you from?
Upstate New York and like places. Tennessee and some different places. Oh, okay. But like just general suburban America, and like there was no context for me to ever think about like what media training would be, or like the things that you say get taken out of context. Like ever, there's just no place for that to exist. And I think that that's just what it is. It's like these. Like young, like very young stars are like so savvy at like this is the brand, this is the presentation, and at home I'm you know butt chugging or something and no one has to know.
Yeah, but you I don't know,
I assume that they're butt chugging a good bit, right? I think you're right on that point.
But do you know how like Britney Spears is basically a zombie at this point?
No, Britney Spears right, is fucking she... dope. No, she's living
you don't
her
think
best
she's
life.
A zombie?
Dude, look at her Twitter. You just once you see the joy in one of her tweets when her son is wearing a Dragon Ball Z costume, that's not fake. That's real.
Right. I've heard rumors that she's like just like sort of like a pod person.
I think she's just a mom.
Yeah, she's just a mom.
She's just lame.
Yeah, I mean I think
she has a big motherfucking house. And her son loves Dragon Ball Z, and she's just hanging out, and that's tight.
Are you telling me, leave Britney alone? Classic that's internet.
Exactly. Man, that's retro at this point. Jeez,
I know, right?
I don't even know what
it's
that's
like
for.
Pulling out
oh, my God. Oh, my God.
That's how retro it is. I don't even know.
You didn't know? You don't
about.
Know that one? That's like one of the first YouTube hits.
What is it? What was
Chris
it?
Crocker, isn't that his name?
Yes, yes, yes.
What did he say, though?
It was like he was a vlogger, and he was, like, crying and holding the camera up, and he was like, you guys need to leave Britney. Like, he was just saying that everybody needs to stop criticizing Britney, just leave her alone, and he just kept screaming, like, leave her alone, and crying.
I maybe
he kind of had, like, an emo.
Yeah,
like,
he had some mascara.
I probably saw it.
Had some mascara that was dripping a little bit. He was up against curtains, too. That's a nice backdrop. Like, he's, like, in the curtain. It's
okay.
Great. It's
are you looking for? Sure really, are you looking it's... for Leave Britney Alone?
Okay, I've seen this.
Can you give us a taste? Can you give us just a little taste of that so we can remember?
Yeah, sure. Hold on, let me pull this up.
That's just all I need right now.
My fucking computer just came, or like my screen came unplugged. Okay, here we go.
Oh, Jesus.
Do we really want to see a 25-year-old woman leave behind two children and die? Have we learned nothing from Anna Nicole Smith? I know it's hard to see Britney Spears'
This is the beginning. I'm going to skip to the end, all right?
Yeah.
Perez Hilton talked about professionalism and said if Britney was a professional, she would have pulled it off no matter what. Speaking of professionalism, when is it professional to publicly bash someone who's going through a hard time? Leave Britney alone!
Yes!
Classic.
Hell yeah, dude.
God. That's classic virality.
If we're God, that's filled me with
SEO show, you know? That. Yeah, it's kind of an SEO classic energy. Moment.
What year is that from?
Good question.
Like 2007 or something.
I think it was even earlier than that.
I think it probably was.
2007? Wow, I was in kindergarten. Damn.
Oh, yeah, it was 2007. I can't believe it. It feels way longer ago. I wanted to say like 4.
No, first of all, I'm amazing. That was a dead ringer. I did not.
Yeah, it really was. Oh, I thought you had it up.
Nope.
Yeah, September 10th, 2007.
No, I just know that.
No, I really just straight up remembered. It was when I was a senior in high school, and I had an Xbox 360, and the world was good. I was playing Halo.
Damn.
It was correction. It wasn't on YouTube. Shout out to Halo. On his MySpace.
It was damn. Earth that just goes to show.
Oh, wait. No, sorry. It was YouTube. Sorry.
Right? Just,
wait. Yeah. I think so.
Zach, what's the first meme you remember? Can you dig for some childhood memes?
That's a really hard one because, like, I'm, like, was never into, like, meme culture. Like, I'm very new to, like, that.
Oh, Ryan, have you dragged him? Have you dragged him into web culture?
Just more into the YouTube world though, like into like the YouTube bro world, like because like YouTube has a lot of worlds, but
it does have a lot of worlds.
I mean, I don't even fucking know. That's such a hard question.
But like when we were looking at Vine though, we were kind of in the meme world. Like Vine was like a meme accelerator.
Right. I mean, I saw all the Vines.
Do you think that Vine brought memes to the... Because there was a time when memes were just internet, like, deep internet shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Vine did bring it.
Vine brought it to... And it also, like, evolved it because, like, I think memes were really, like, a still image. And they still, in a lot of ways, are, but... I think
a true meme is, right?
You think a meme is
like
a still
true
image?
Meme is an image. I don't know. That's kind of what I thought.
Well, no. So, I mean, like, memes back then, I think, were more, like, accidental. You know what I mean? Where, like, you know, somebody would post something and somebody would use it in different contexts and people would be like, wow, that is hilarious. You know, like a Tumblr reblog with, like, a killer quote at the bottom.
Yeah.
And then Vine was when people started to like really be like, I want to create memes. My the thing I'm trying to do is to meme.
Right.
I think people are always trying to meme though. Like aren't on Imgur, that site? I don't know if that's how you pronounce
it.
Yeah,
dude. Oh my god.
Imgur, I didn't even know Imgur was like a meme competition site. I just thought it was like sort of like a just upload your photos.
Oh god, you remember those horrible memes that everyone thought were that they the original meme was like the face with the star pattern colors behind it?
Yeah.
Yeah, the
okay. You mean like the stripes?
Faces. The stripes, yes. And then all, the later was foo faces, or maybe foo faces was before.
You mean
that.
Like was that? Are you talking about rage faces?
Yeah,
is rage that another faces. Name for them? I don't know. It's called foo. I thought they were called rage.
F and then several U's.
I thought it was like rage comics, though. Wasn't that what
I
it was from?
So.
Or not?
I guess. Yeah. No, I think you're right.
You know what I'm talking about, Zach?
What?
It's sort of like they're like a bunch. It's basically like. Its own set of emojis,
yeah.
Because it's like a whole library of like black and white.
What
faces.
The fuck is this?
If you search rage face, you'll know. And they're kind of just like a lot of really extreme emotions. And it's like, and who knows who drew them all? They're like sort of like crowdsourced, I'm sure. Like
yeah,
like people sort of scrawled cartoons that looked like this.
Yeah.
And sometimes somebody would nail like a face that's like just scribbly enough, but like
it's like Invader Zim. That's what it reminds me of.
Yeah, I would say in that Invader Zim was very.
It has
like,
that. It has that energy. It has that dramatic energy for sure.
But I remember because like I went on 4chan. You know, these were like a 4chan style meme. Like,
right.
Yeah.
And I saw a lot of people would do like they would take the good face, like one of these classic rage faces, and they would draw the comic around it, and then like the punchline would always be, the face would end up like this, like one of these. You know what I mean?
Man. Okay. So. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So, okay, we have two different things in the timeline here. The stripe faces that were very, like, Reddit, like, early Reddit bullshit.
Yeah.
The rage faces that were very 4chan bullshit. Wait.
Okay.
And if you go even farther back than that, like...
I was going to tell you the first meme that I really knew.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah,
okay, which is probably like, fuck, I don't even know, like 2009. That was probably the first time I even knew about memes. Like the fucking Willy Wonka one.
Like, oh, like the reaction face Willy Wonka.
Yeah, where he's like has his hand on his head, like leaning on his head.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that's like the first one that's when I was like, oh, okay, this is like a meme. Okay. And I really liked this one. Like, I remember liking it. Like, it was like something about cigarettes. I remember thinking it was funny.
That's good. That's very Facebookable. Like, that was a.
Yeah, I think that's where it came from. Cause, like, I mean, I never was searching on the internet. Like, I was never that curious.
Oh, man. I could tell you so many different things. Ronald, do you remember the age before memes, the like Flash website?
I mean, I was going to say, like, if you mean like Hamster Dance.
Yeah, like Hamster. Yeah, like the Newgrounds.
Bullshit. Yeah, yeah. I mean,
what
I feel
the
like
fuck is Hamster Grounds.
No, Hamster Dance. You know, Hamster Dance. Hamster Dance to me, or Dancing Baby, was the original meme, and I feel like a lot of people say that.
I think I know
Dancing Hamster Dance. Dancing Baby is for sure an extremely early prototype of a meme for sure.
But like,
doesn't have a nice modern punchline, but like, yeah.
Zach, do you don't remember Hamster Dance on our computer at home? Like,
I when it was new? Kinda do.
That was like when we first got the internet. That was one of the first things I did.
When did you guys get the internet?
I want to say it was like 2001 or two. Right, yeah. Zach?
I think it was before that.
Was it?
I think we had a fucking like 97 probably.
I really don't think so, actually, but I don't know.
Yeah, but things were definitely different then. Like, you might have been You might have been booting Windows 95 like on a computer in 1999.
I remember we had 98.
Windows 98. We had Windows XP. I was a good enough nerd that I would like get the newest shit.
Yeah, baby.
But...
oh, actually, I updated my computer to the next version of Windows today.
Nice.
There's an update?
Well, no, it's you have to like opt into it. It's like the public beta of the next version.
Ew.
But I can't tell that literally anything is different.
Like, I was looking at the I don't even know. I have Windows on this one computer and I hate it, but it just like has random screensaver and it just like shows random locations from around the world, like landscapes.
Yeah,
and there was like one of the most striking, beautiful landscapes I've ever seen. So, a shout out to Windows because like that was cool
for like the lock screen wallpaper.
Yeah,
I know.
I was like, wow, this is very beautiful.
Did you save it?
No, I don't know. I don't even know where it was.
If there's a little tiny, almost hidden button in the top right that's just like, hey, this is pretty tight.
I hope it shows up again.
See, that's nice. I like serendipity and. Computers, that's cool.
Right. But yes, Windows... I think the Windows people would be psyched to hear that. Yeah. I don't know who to contact.
Considering everything else about Windows, like Zach, Brian, and I have a mutual friend, Thomas, and he's like a computer master.
Yeah,
he was sharing with me his like custom Mac like keyboard commands that you can like chain together to like make different macros happen.
Right,
he's like a computer maestro, and sure. I'm just like on my. Garbage computer just being like, well, that sounds cool.
Wish
I could do that. That sounds
that's neat. Why yeah Tom, speaking of like Star Trek, I feel like he just like sort of wants to be Jean-Luc Picard, like with like all the controls at his fingertips, you know.
Absolutely. I need to give him some, like, accessory pads.
He definitely likes to. That's, like, where ideally where he would be in the world is, like, on a bridge.
Like, he should have, like, a chaos pad, like, next to his keyboard. To, like, do some, like...
That's a deep audio joke.
I don't know what that means. So, I mean, that went over my head, so.
Just, like, a flat, like, touch screen where you, like, drag your finger across to, like, change, like the tone of, like, a noise.
It's just, like, audio modulator.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I can see that in a heartbeat.
Well... But no,
yeah.
Damn. So,
do you have any days of the week, Zach?
Oh, okay. Shit!
Usually, this time you've pulled up some holidays.
I totally blanked. I was like, "What the fuck?" I was like, "Is this like show gonna be over or what?" Like,
What is this new segment? I don't know what this is.
No, Zach.
I usually just interject.
Usually, whenever our topics are getting low, Zach just starts throwing in like what holiday it is, like what obscure holiday.
Yeah, I like go to the shitty like website.
Can I just say we didn't have a show last week, but like I was traveling on last Tuesday, and it was Avocado Day last Tuesday, and before I knew it was Avocado Day, I was noticing all these people at the airport wearing avocado shirts. Just random people were out there representing avocados on Avocado Day.
Do you think that's kind of weird?
Do you think they're part of Big Avocado?
No, I actually think people are just kind of excited about avocados. I think that like the some stereotypes are real. I think snake people, aka millennials, like avocados a lot. Because, like, do you like avocados?
I fucking love avocados.
I like them, too. Like, not enough to rave about them, but I feel like if I kind of like them a lot, there's got to be people out there that are just, like, raging over avocados and looked forward to wearing their avocado shirt the other day.
Oh, man.
Especially to the airport, you know? They're going to be around a lot of people they want to represent. Yeah,
what goes through your head being like, I'm traveling today, I'm going to fucking rep avocados, and not just, like, your most comfortable...
I really think people really like going to the airport and, like, I don't know, picking out an outfit. Traveling is still kind of a fun event for a lot of people.
Well, I wish I could say that. When I go to the airport, I'm like, man, I want to be, like, sedated.
So
if someone could shrink me and just put my body on the plane, that'd be amazing.
Throw you in a bag.
Hey, guys, do you like root beer floats by chance?
Absolutely.
No, I don't.
Well, Evan, you're going to be very happy to hear that today is National Root Beer Float Day. So grab some ice cream and grab some root beer, scoop it up, pour it down, and drink it up.
Can I ask you a question, Evan?
Yeah, sure.
How do you keep your belly from blowing up huge?
Like bloating?
Because milk plus soda pop inside your body, you'll have permanent bubbles.
I don't know about permanent, but yeah, it's pretty.
But have you ever blown bubbles in milk?
It tastes good, though.
Those bubbles stay there forever, and that's what happens with the carbonation and the milk in your stomach, and you get like a big pot belly. And it's like, it feels dangerous.
It does feel dangerous, but that's part of the appeal. Really?
Stretching your stomach out?
Yeah.
It kind of goes with another holiday today. Today is Wiggle Your Toes Day. So sit back, drink a root beer float, and wiggle them toes.
Wow, I can't believe that's a day, but I kind of like that.
Yeah.
Are you guys wiggling them right now?
Yeah, I'm wiggling them.
You know what, like, kind of puts me in a mood when I'm sitting back enjoying a root beer float, maybe listening to some reggae. And today in 1962 was Jamaicans' independence. So give a yaman to all the Jamaicans out there.
Yeah, man.
That felt weird, but congratulations, Jamaicans.
The Caribbean island country was first colonized by the Spanish in the early 16th century. In 1655, the British invaded Spanish Jamaica and made it a colony after the Spanish surrendered. Jamaica soon became one of the most profitable colonies of the British Empire, especially after sugarcane was brought to the island by the English. The Jamaican Independence Act of July 1962, which was resulted in of anti-colonial sentiment.
that were spreading throughout the globe gave Jamaica full independence by leaving the Federation of the West Indies. So you go, Jamaica, national, it's their Independence Day. That's sweet.
Feel the rhythm, feel the rhyme. So it's their 4th of July?
Exactly, exactly.
Do you think that they, what do you think they do? Just fireworks, or you think they light up something else, if you know what I'm saying?
Did we lose someone?
Evan dipped out.
Yeah, I mean, I assume that, you know, everyone just watching Cool Runnings, it's on repeat.
Oh, is that sort of like...
I don't think Evan was liked that joke, so I think he left for that. So we got to get it out now before he comes back.
I mean, I would say that. Do you think that Jamaica is mad about that movie? I think that movie.
I think that movie. It's pretty good. It's a pretty great tale. But should we get Evan back on, or should?
Yeah. Let's get Evan back. When we come back, we are going to finish up the Boyz Night. Oh, sorry, I don't have Boyz Night to play again. I'll play Kung Lao.
It's a Boyz Night. No girls. It's a Boyz Night.
It's a Boyz Night out.
All right. Welcome back.
Boyz Night out. No girls. I don't know
where Darius Sweat is. I think that he didn't like the their Jamaican accents.
You think he was offended?
I think he might have.
You think he didn't
been.
Want to be associated with that?
I don't know. That's my suspicion.
I think you're allowed to do a Jamaican.
That's one that's okay. Like, I think the Jamaicans are like, you could do it. It's fine. Like, we don't care.
I don't think they're happy about it, but...
But, like, here's the thing.
It's like an English accent, right?
Here's my argument. If you can do a fucking American accent, I don't give a fuck.
I think it's different, but I also feel like... I don't know. Maybe I feel like you didn't like how I said that only Asian ladies use umbrellas and masks.
He didn't seem to be offended by that one.
Okay. Sorry to the Asian ladies who out there were offended. Like, honestly, I was just, like, impressed.
Well, it's a cultural thing, right? So,
I think so. Man, what have we got ourselves into?
We fucked up. We got to apologize to the entire country of Jamaica.
Sorry, Jamaica. Sorry, Asia.
Sorry for Jamaican you crazy. Okay, that was the last one. Let's try to get Evan back on the line one more time.
All right. No girls. It's a Boyz Night Out. I think Evan really was mad. So this is the part of the show. Finally, we got some drama on the show. This is like, if this is a reality show, this is where it go.
Fuck.
Evan didn't like the accents, and so he left.
This is never. Guys, like, can we just you know, hit pause for a second, because this has never happened before. So we're kind of like, really don't know what to do. So you're on board on the ride with us.
I'm gonna message him on WhatsApp, and I'm gonna say, "Yo, dude."
Say,
what is should
yeah,
I say?
Do it. Yeah, say what's up, or what's up, you drop. Yeah, like be casual about it. Like, okay. Don't mention anything about the Jamaican stuff.
Okay. You got the message. I just sent it.
Oh, okay.
Fuck.
This is not
like cool. We're kind of joking here, guys, but actually, I don't know.
You think he's gonna fucking just totally bail on Yosemite?
Maybe.
Fuck. Shit.
Do you think maybe we are bad people, though?
A little bit.
I mean, I'm just being honest. Yeah, like a little bit. But it's for you guys.
I don't think
it's for the fans. It's for the fans, at least for me. You know what? We fucked up.
It's
then responded. We should have known. 1 minute.
We should have known we couldn't handle Boyz Nite.
Shit.
Power.
Dang. Should we call Tree? Should we call Tree and tell her what happened?
Let's see if we can get her on the horn. Okay. We'll be right back. No girls, no girls, no girls, no girls. It's a Boyz Nite out.
What's
no
up,
girls,
guys?
No girls. It's a Boyz Nite out. So we're back.
And no response. No still. Answers.
Do you think that maybe something's wrong with Hanker?
I want to say yes, but I think in my heart, I think Anchor's fine.
I think it might be fine too.
Shit.
Evan, I'm so sorry. That wasn't real. Let's see.
Yeah, that seemed really fake. Start over.
Okay. Look, I don't know much about Jamaica. I'm a guy that grew up on the mainland. What do I know? All I know is what she showed me up on that big silver screen. And when I get the spotlight, I choke. This is kind of like a Mighty Ducks speech, but
I mean, all I have to say is this kind of like reminds me of like like whenever they're trying to get like Coach Bombay to be their coach. Like they're trying to like get Irv, but he like is kind of just like doesn't want anything to do with them, and he like is trying to hit him. He tries to hit him with like the pool stick at the bat, and then they go and follow him into the bathroom, and they're like, "Hey," and like he's getting all pissed.
I think you've seen this more than me, but yeah, that sounds like what's happening here.
Okay, well, I guess we better end the show.
You know, his phone might have just died. Really. But maybe,
yeah, I mean, guys. Actually, you know what? You could be right. That could be actually what happened. You know what? We'll talk about it next week. Actually, we'll probably talk to you before that, but
we'll definitely keep you posted on whether Evan is mad about us talking a Jamaican accent.
Yeah, we should actually maybe follow up with him. And can we add this to the show? Add that to the show?
Yeah, definitely. If there's another segment after this, that means we found out whether Evan was mad at us.
Nice. Anyways, go ahead and rate us in the Apple Store and follow this show on Spotify or whatever podcast platform you are using.
Thank you. Yeah. See you next week. SEO show will be coming live from Inyo National Forest, maybe. I think next week SEO show will probably be more like a vibes fest, like not like the opposite of SEO, like sort of just good vibes, like podcast. Like maybe it's like another podcast.
Cool.
All right, thanks. We'll see you next week, or you know, maybe we'll be back with Evan. 94,